Hey guys, welcome back to Calico Flower Studio. I'm Dani, and today I'm going to work in my visual journal again, and I'm going to talk about one of my values, which is simplicity. But before I do that, I first want to acknowledge that this channel over the past few weeks or so has like tripled, if not quadrupled, the number of subscribers to this channel. And I've also been getting a lot of comments from people all over the world that I've never met. And they're incredibly thoughtful comments. And I just want to say that I'm just like blown away. I don't know how or why this is happening, but I can only hope that it's because this content is resonating with people, and that means so much to me. So I just wanted to take a moment to acknowledge that. And everybody who has recently subscribed, welcome. I am so glad that you're here, and please feel free to leave me comments or join my newsletter, and we can really foster a meaningful connection and just kind of reflect on life through the lens of mixed media, which is what I'm here to do. So thank you so much for watching, and I hope that you enjoy. So today I'm going to keep it simple, and I am going to document a project that I'm working on in my visual journal. And in doing this, I want to also share some thoughts about one of my values, simplicity. I think that my collages can be a little maximalist. And so I try my best to get down to the bare bones or the essence of something, which can be very difficult. I mean, in my creative practice, it's one thing, but also in my life, it's a whole other thing. Our minds are very good, are very creative, actually. We invent so many circumstances, and we come up with all of this information and interpretations of things, and sometimes it can be hard to differentiate what of those is important or if any of it is important at all. One thing that I try to practice, and I emphasize the word try to practice, is being, you know. It's so simple to just be and to be present in this moment, because it's just as simple as what's happening right now. But anyway, not to run off the rails too much, I value simplicity. And so today, the collage that I'm going to make I'm sitting on the floor right now because I like to work on the floor. I am comfortable on the floor. This is kind of like my comfort zone. I don't need a tablecloth or a table for this, because all I'm going to be using are a pair of scissors, my journal, and these trimmings from a commission that I am working on. This painting that I'm working on is a large painting on canvas. This is canvas, but it's unstretched, so I bought like a huge roll of it and cut it to size. But before, you know, as I was working on the painting, I allowed for a bleed space, so to speak, you know, and I used blue tape, this painter's tape, to mark off the finished space of the canvas. So I'm left with these pieces of tape after, so I've trimmed this off of the painting. And I'm left with these pieces of tape that have just the edges of the painting. And so they're like my little souvenirs. I like to think of them as my little diary of the painting, because you can see the different colors I was using, maybe different patterns or mark making techniques, different textures. And it's like, it's kind of like a little chronicle of that painting. I like to call this the energy of the edges. The energy of the edges. This is something I've done before in the past when I created my master's thesis project, which I will include a link to a video that I just posted that just shows, just really it's just featuring the finished painting. But in the process of making that painting, I also did this technique where I sectioned off unstretched canvas with blue tape and then trimmed it when the painting was complete. And then I had leftover tape from that project that I saved in my journals as like my little souvenir of this piece. So first, I already used some trimmings because this commission is two panels. And so the first panel I trimmed the other day, and I just find it so beautiful and fascinating to hang on to these memories, the energy of the edges. And so I think this page is pretty neat, but actually I am just totally crazy about this page right here, because with the color of the pages of this notebook, because all the pages are made of these colorful envelopes, the colors on in the tape just so happen to coordinate very well with the color of the envelopes. It just looks really cool. And there's another one back here too that is also pretty well coordinated. But today I trimmed the other painting, the other panel, because there were two panels. So I have a whole new set of tape that I'm going to cut up and put into my journal with you as I talk about simplicity. And this is obviously like a very simple act, because I'm not super concerned with composition. I already know. I just want to literally let the tape just be what it is and put it on here in a simple way, just, you know, lined up similar to how you see here, just across the page, just like that. And I'm not going to think much about the order of the tape. And I'm going to just work with whatever comes up in this, on this canvas. So I guess that kind of brings me to my first reflection on this value of simplicity, is that to me, it is a lot of accepting things for what they are and taking them with it as they are, and allowing them to be, to just be. And that takes a lot of burden off of the thinking mind to create something super specific, and just allowing life to happen through me. If that makes sense. Sorry, I feel like that's like kind of a very profound statement that could use a lot more explanation, but I hope that resonates if you're in a place to be thinking about things like that. It's just allowing things to emerge as opposed to trying to force anything. And I think that happens a lot with me in my artwork, where I am really trying hard to will something into being, as opposed to just taking pieces for what they are and then allowing something to surface from that on its own, a little more organically, and not putting so much pressure on myself to make it be a certain way. So just keeping it simple. Now, what page do I want to, I think I might want to do this page or not. Let's see. I'm trying to pick a good page. I think this could be fun. This page right here with some of the tape that we've got going on. Okay, great. So, oh, and before I begin, actually, I'll show you some of the tape diaries from my thesis project. As you can see, the outside of this book has been embellished with pieces of tape. There are a few other, so yes, for example, I would store these pieces of tape in various places on my notebook. Ah, right here. It's so accidentally beautiful. If you have been with me on this channel for a while, you already know that I am all about repurposing material, and a lot of that is residual material from projects, you know, and this is a perfect example of residual product of a painting. These pieces of tape, and so I'm going to use them. So what I'm doing is I am going to take these pieces of canvas and just sort of pull them across, and as I find sections of tape that I want to lay into this two-page spread on my sketchbook, I'm going to make cuts and then just peel the tape off and stick it in there. It's as simple as that. It's so simple. And it's so relaxing and fun and satisfying. So satisfying. I mean, if you've ever peeled anything, you know how satisfying that is. So, and then to see it all laid out in the page when it's complete, and then also too, like the journey, the process of it, and seeing all these patterns and shapes emerge as I add each piece of tape is fun. It's so fun. So anyway, I'm going to show you what I mean here. So I've just cut on both sides, and now I can just peel this tape off. Oh yeah, it's good stuff. So I'm just gonna start from the top and see what comes, see what happens. I love the texture in this one. Look at all that paint. Okay. So I hold the tape over the two-page spread to determine how much space I can leave as I cut, so that it will all fit on the page. It doesn't necessarily have to fit on the page, though. Like in my other journal that I just showed you, I had lots of tape like wrapping around to the next page. I had tape going at different angles. I mean, you can get a little funky with it, but in lieu of today's theme, I am just going to keep it simple. Love the polka dots. So fun. I will definitely be creating a video sort of chronicling the process of making these paintings as well, this commission. So you can look forward to that. But it's still in progress, so stay tuned. I'm gonna work on that later today, actually. So I'm actually going to choose to make this a little shorter because of the way that I want these marks to be grouped on the same strip of tape. So not all the rows have to be the same length. But yeah, you know, just thinking, oh shit. Just thinking about simplicity, in my life and not just in art, is very important. Like, so I am an independent artist, but I am also an arts administrator. And so sometimes, that aspect of me speaks to, my skills in being like organized. So I am like obsessed with organizational tools, productivity tools, kind of, and, like scheduling and, you know, making sense of what can be a lot of overwhelming information and tasks, and moving parts, right? As like a director of a program. So and then as someone who like also sees the nuance in so many, in everything, and you know, that's just my lens, my mode of thinking about things, is that I like to notice nuances and like complexities in certain circumstances or situations. And so it's like, it can be a challenge for me in life to, I like overcomplicate things sometimes. And so it's super helpful for me to remember to regularly come back to this value of simplicity. It's like, how can I accomplish my goals while also, keeping, keeping it clear, simple and clear. It's like clarity is a huge aspect of simplicity. And I think that kind of hits it on the nail on the head right there, is that word clarity. That's just like, I need things to be simple so that I can have clarity on them, you know? That's interesting. Well, I'm gonna move on to another page, but check that out. How cool is that? I love it. And then I might come back to this page later. See, that's the thing about my visual journal, is I don't necessarily move in chronological order. Like, you'll see that, I mean, of course, you know, in the beginning I sort of started off in the first pages, but then as I got going, I started jumping around. So I like skipped these pages and I went to this page, skipped these. Now I'm using this page today, but I skipped them before as well, you know, all of these, to do this page here. And so I don't move chronologically, I guess, from left to right all the time, which is fine. And then I will probably, to make this page, I revisited it like 3 or 4 different times and added different layers and sort of transformed it in different ways until I felt good about it. And so I think this is my final iteration, but who knows, maybe I'll come back to this page and add like little writings or like quotes or something. So, you know, it's all developing at the same time. It's not necessarily happening in any particular order or, you know, any sort of standard of any state of being finished. You know, it's always in progress. I always come back to different things, but anyway, on that note, the next strip I'm taking a look at. How cool is that? Okay, so the last, we're gonna do one more because I've got one left. Or do I? Yeah, this is the last one. I have one left. So this one's a little simple. Lots of interesting shapes. A lot of cool like whites and blues. Some light greens. So let's see. What can we do here? Oh, this is the back page, which got a little wrinkled, and that's why I didn't put this one in my store. This was kind of like, I made this journal when I was still learning how to make the journals. So it's a little messed up on the back. They don't usually look like this, but I think I'm gonna just use this back page here. Yeah. Finish it up. A little ASMR for you. Love it. And this one. Finally, this one over here on this side. So, I hope that this gave you some food for thought, especially surrounding the idea of keeping it simple, whether it's in your creative practice or in whatever kind of work you do, or just in your life in general, in your relationships, in the way you approach problem solving. I could probably say a lot more about this topic, so I'd love to continue the conversation in the comments section, so please leave me a comment and I'll definitely respond. And if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe. It means the world to me to know that these videos are reaching lots of people and resonating with them, and I am looking forward to connecting with you if you have not subscribed yet. So, yeah, thanks again, and I will see you next time. Take care.